Over the centuries, paper has been made from wide variety of materials from wood pulp, rice, water plants, cotton, even from old cloth. But no matter what you use to make paper, you need fiber. Today's paper fiber comes mainly from trees that are purposefully harvested. And basically, in this video, we are going to see three steps of making paper. From trees to logs, from logs to pulp, and from pulp to paper. Step 1. Trees to logs. The most common trees that are used to make paper are pine, eucalyptus, larch, aspen, etc. Because the cellulose fibers in the pulp of these species are longer for making a stronger paper. These trees are called softwood by the paper industry. Step 2. From logs to pulp. First, the logs are washed with steam or hot water to remove dirt, sand, etc. Then logs are trimmed so they did not get stuck at the next stage in the process, which is debarking. The wood is fed into the debarking drum. When the logs passed through the debarking drum, they rub against one another, thus losing the bark from the wood. Then there is a metal detector that can detect very small pieces of metal. These must be removed. The logs then fed into a chipper, where they fall into a rotating disc with sharp cutting blades, which converts the wood into small pieces called wood chips. These wood chips are fed into a digester, where they are boiled in an acid solution to dissolve lignin and separate the fibers. The pulp obtained from this process is wood-free because the lignin has been dissolved. Then the fibers are washed to remove the acid solution. And now step 3, converting pulp to paper. Before it can be used to make white paper, the pulp is bleached. To protect the environment, this bleaching is chlorine-free using oxygen and peroxide. Then the pulp is mixed with water. Approximately about 100 liters of fresh water are needed to make 1 kilogram of paper. So think before you print, burn or wasting paper. Wood fibers alone would produce rough textured and unevenly dense paper. So fillers such as calcium carbonate and clay are mixed in to make paper more opaque and give it a more controlled density. Then dyes, optical brighteners and sizers are blended into the paper to improve appearance of the paper. And then pulp is fed into the fore-dryer machine on a moving belt of fine mesh screening. The pulp is squeezed through a series of rollers while the suction device below the belt drains off water. Then the paper moves onto the wet press section, where it is pressed between rollers of wood felt. And next, it passes through dryer section, contains series of steam heated cylinders to remove the remaining water. And finally, paper reaches calendar section. It uses rollers mounted opposite of each other to put pressure on the paper to create a smooth finish. After completing all this journey, the paper is wound into large reels, where it will be further processed for making books, print papers, etc. And these are some of the basic steps involved in manufacturing of paper.